The other day, a friend of mine called me and said, "Hey, I'm managing this process in a spreadsheet and it's a mess." And this conversation made me realize that a lot of the work that we do here on this channel with our videos doesn't go back to the root, which is helping people find a better way to solve their problems. And so in this video, I really want to take things back to the basics. I'm going to be building from scratch a better solution for tracking your inventory inside of a no-code tool and getting away from that spreadsheet mentality. If you are currently stuck in spreadsheets and you know there has to be a better way to solve your problems, you are going to love this video. So stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back. My name is Gareth Pronovost and I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, where we help you unlock your potential with no-code tools and really help you transition out of spreadsheets, which are just being used in so many cases for projects and processes that they're not a good fit for. In this video, I'm going to show you how easy it is to set up your own SmartSuite account so that you can track some inventory items inside of this. And the best part about what I'm talking about here is this is fully customizable. As you'll see as I'm building, this is just an example of how we can do this, but you can fully customize this to fit your process. Now, first we're gonna go ahead and sign on into SmartSuite, and it looks like a very colorful version of maybe a Google Drive or something like that. And inside here, each one of these items is its own database. These databases can talk to each other, we can connect them, it's really amazing. But I don't want you to get freaked out about the word database. This is really super easy to build, as you'll see in just a moment. Now we're gonna be building this from scratch, so go ahead and follow along with me in your own SmartSuite account. If you're not already a SmartSuite user, please sign up using our link here for the channel. It's a great way for you to send some love back to us. So what I'm gonna do is go ahead and add a new solution, and I will create from scratch. And the first thing I need to think about is what are the different sets of data that I'm going to be working with? The different collections of information. Now, in a spreadsheet, we would kind of put everything on one place, right? And it becomes just a big mess. And that's part of the reason it's so unwieldy. But inside of SmartSuite, inside of any no-code tool, when we organize our data, we're doing it in collections. And so for us, we're tracking inventory. We're gonna imagine a scenario where people can come in and check in or out these different inventory items. So how do we do this? It's pretty simple. Number one, we have the inventory itself. That is one set of data. Number two, we're gonna have the check in or check out process. This is connected to or relating to the inventory items, right? But it's its own set of data. When did somebody check something out? What did they check out? When did they check it back in? And then, you might have heard me, I just said it, the third set of data is who is doing the checking in or out. Not only the person who's checking it in, like the admin user, but also where is it going? Who is the actual person? If you imagine a library, for example, whose library card did we scan to send that book out? That is the third set of data. So when we consider these different collections of information inside of no code, we build them into their own data sets or tables. So this table right here, table one, I'll rename to be the first one. This is inventory. The second one I will rename or create here, create from scratch, and I'm going to name it check in or out. And the third one will be the users or the people that have access to the different inventory items that they can check in or out of our system. Now I need to kind of build out the structure for these three different components. And I can do it all from scratch, just as I added these tables so easily by hitting the plus sign here. I can add new fields here inside of each table as well. I'm going to take just a moment to kind of fill this out with the different kinds of information I need to collect for each of these data sets. So I filled out some information here, cleaned this up a little bit. Let's look at our people table. The one that we set up here has a full name, so we can put the name of the person. Also, we're collecting other information that relates to that person. So if they're late on returning something, for example, we know how to get a hold of them. So in this case, we have their address, we have their phone number, and we can collect other information as well. Now over here on inventory, you're gonna see something similar. We're naming the items, we've got a color picker so we can select that. And ultimately, we wanna be able to tell ourselves, where is all of our inventory at any point in time? Like, for example, has somebody checked it out? Do we have it in our warehouse? Like, where is every item? That's what we're trying to solve for. And that's really why a spreadsheet is insufficient. Now, the third component is the check in or out process. And so we have not filled this out yet. We're going to do it together because this is where things get a little bit more complicated. We're going to start getting this table, this set of data, talking to the other stuff. It's all going to connect. When somebody checks something out, they're checking out an inventory item. So what we do is we build what's called a link to our other table. We build a link, in this case, to inventory. So I'm going to rename this field to inventory. We want to know at every check-in or every check-out, who is checking it in, but what are they checking in or out as well? So here's where we can attach what we're linking to. Right now, I haven't named this database yet. It's still called Untitled Solution, but the inventory table is where we want to connect. And with each check-in or check-out, I'm only interested in one item. So I'm not going to link to multiple items. So let's go ahead and add this field and you'll see what this looks like. When I go to create a new record, I'm going to see a list of all of the inventory on this table here, thing one through thing four. Now, similarly, I want to add people. So let's bring in a link to people here. I'm going to go for a linked record again, and this time to people. And I'm going to link not to inventory, but now to people in my untitled solution. And again, when somebody checks something out, only one person's checking that thing out. So let's add a field. And what else do I care about? Well, I need to know when this happened. What is the created date or time? This is actually a field that we already have access to. If we go up to our fields to display, you can see when a record is first created. This is metadata, meaning we don't even have to enter it. When the record comes into existence, we know when that is. It's timestamped. It's going to be captured right here. Way better than a spreadsheet. Next, we're going to go in here and say, is this a check-in or a check-out? So let's do a single select field. This is a drop-down, and I'm just going to say in/out. So let's go ahead and fill out two options. It's either going to be checked in or checked out. And up here for the name, it's going to be in/out. So let's add the field. And now we can start putting this all together. Now, the last component is actually naming every record. So what I want to do is actually pull information from the other pieces of this record. So the name or the ID is going to be auto-generated. This is going to save me a ton of time. It's less data that I have to manually input. And what I'm going to do is simply say, I want to take whoever checked it out, the person, in this case, we called that people, and I'm going to separate that with a line, and then I'll bring in the inventory, and then maybe I'll also include the status of in or out. Let's find that. So you see that I'm able to reference all the different components inside of my data set. In fact, I'll even include that first created on. So this is now going to be an automatically generated ID. Let's take a look at how all the information will flow. We create a record and we say, well, what was checked out? Thing three, okay? Who did it? Who checked it out? See, we have a link to the other table, so we only see the information that's there. And when is it created? This will be automatically generated when we save. And was it checked in or checked out? In. So now that this is done, you'll see that it was created on this day. We checked something in. It was this thing. And this is who did it. This is the person who had it in their possession. So now we can easily track where is everything at every moment in time. If you have a second more, just to take this a step further, we can even add a form directly inside of our now brand new solution. In order to do that, we'll come down to the bottom left and we'll add a new view type called a form. And on the form, we can decide what information is required upon every new submission. The best part is this does not even require us to set this up with any kind of automation. We just click and drag. So I'm going to say, I want to bring inventory in. I want to bring people in. I want to know, was it checked in or out? What's the status? And of course, that created date, as I mentioned, it's metadata. We don't need to say when it was. It's going to be captured automatically. Now, when we're ready, we can simply deploy the form, and that's how information is going to get added to our database. We can share this form. This is a publicly available URL. We can also lock it down if we want to put extra permissions on this, but we'll toggle on that share view, and we'll open up the actual live form itself. This is available to be embedded on a website, whatever we want, and we can also customize the appearance. So here I am. I select the inventory. Let's say thing three was checked out by Joe. Simple, submit that information. Back in our database now, we're going to see that record automatically created, just that simply. This is going to allow you to have such an easier time managing all of your information. If you're interested in learning more about how all of this can save you a ton of time, we have put together an automation training webinar for you so that you can start to leverage even more power from these tools. Grab that training at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. I will include a link below where you found this video. I hope you got a ton of value from this. If you did, swing by our YouTube channel. Be sure to subscribe, but most importantly, keep on building.